Dr. Richard Wolff drops by to talk about modern monetary theory and the Democratic Party and all this sort of stuff. Check it out. Leave your comments. Ding the bell. And if you find it of value, subscribe to our channel. Well, modern monetary theory, this is becoming actually a point of contention within the Democratic Party. Stephanie Keldon, one of the most outspoken persons in this area, or experts in this area, she's been on this program many times over the years, was Bernie's chief economics advisor for a couple of years. I'm not sure if she still is. What are your thoughts on modern monetary theory? How would you summarize it, first off, for people who don't know what we're talking about? And then, you know, is it a good idea? Is it crazy? What is it, in your opinion?
Okay, yeah, let me try very briefly to summarize it. In all courses in money and banking, which are taught as a routine matter in every college and university, literally in the United States, the story about money goes roughly like this. Money is controlled by the Federal Reserve. It has the authority to literally to print the dollar bills or the $100 bills, to mint the coins, and to circulate them into the economy in a variety of ways. The Federal Reserve is partly a creature of government and partly a creature of the private banking system in the United States. It has an independence because leaving money in the hands of politicians purely and simply proved to be very dangerous for the economy of the United States, even though leaving it in the hands of private banks, which is the way we did it before the government was brought in, also proved to be extremely dangerous. And the reason for that is important to remember. Leaving the control of the money supply in the hands of banks, whose first priority is their own bottom line, profit for their shareholders, big bucks for their leading executives, means that you're doing something that we all depend on. It's a social thing, the money supply, and leaving it in the hands of people who look at it as a source of private profit is a recipe for the disasters that made us bring the government in. So with that as the background, here's how it works, or at least this is the idea. The federal government prints the money, literally the dollars and the coins. Those then are deposited in banks by people who want safekeeping in the bank. The bank now has the money in its hands and has the legal right to lend part of that money out. It keeps part of it in the bank as a security, as a reserve, but it lends the money out. That's where you get the phrase, banks are institutions that lends out other people's money. That's literally correct. It's other people put the money in as a deposit, and the bank lends it out. That's the idea. That's what we teach. Here's the problem. Modern monetary theory, Stephanie Kelton and her associates, who used to be grouped mainly at the University of Missouri in Kansas City, a group of very intelligent, very creative economists, basically did research and said there's a fundamental flaw here. Banks have, for all their history, not done what the theory teaches people they do. And here's what they meant. When a bank issues a loan, nowadays, all that it does is create an account for the recipient of the loan, and then the bank deposits into that account the amount of money that they have lent to the borrower. In other words, the bank is not dependent on other people putting deposits in because the bank creates not only the loan based on the deposit, but on the deposit itself. And the criticism of the modern monetary theorists is we should never have, and we should not now, put the control of the money supply so utterly into the hands of the banks for all the reasons of the historical record of how they then mismanaged it that led us to bring the government in. That's the first kind of critical impulse behind this theory. The second, and that's all that I have to say about it, the second is they have a proposal. Since creating loans and creating deposits is done more or less in the same act, we should have the creation of money brought back under the complete control of the government. They are in favor of that. They think that the democratic control of the government is a much better reliable source of managing the money than putting it in the hands, as we now do, of private banks. So they want the government, basically, when it spends money, to literally create the money it uses to buy things, whether it's infrastructure or paying military salaries or building roads or, you know, all of that, that the government will print the money it needs to do its business. And if it turns out that they've printed more money than there are goods and services to pay for, so that they drive up prices, that's where an inflation can occur, then the government can use its taxing power to pull the money out of the economy, just as it will use its printing power to put the money in. And in both cases, the notion is that a democratic process of controlling the government assures us that the money supply will be increased or decreased as needed by the society as a whole, and not as dictated by the profit considerations of private banks. That's their basic idea, and there's been an enormous debate, because obviously if you're a conservative, you want to keep it in the hands of banks, or at least most of them do, whereas if you're a more liberal or leftist, then the notion that the government, hopefully democratically controlled, does this is more appealing to you. And that fight is being had not only inside the Democratic Party, but in the pages of our financial press, as one or another famous economist chooses his or her sides in this ongoing dispute.
Right. Now, one of the conversations that I had with Stephanie Kelton some years ago, and I may be misremembering, but my understanding was, you know, we've got this big debt, the U.S. debt, and I didn't recall that she was calling for eliminating the Fed or anything like that. But basically, the minting of coins uniquely is the province of the Treasury Department, not the Fed. The coins in your pocket are actually, and it's in the Constitution, which is why the Fed doesn't do coins; it only does paper money and digital money. And
correct.
Right, so she suggested that the Treasury could order the Mint to make $21 trillion coins and out of platinum, and not literally worth $1 trillion worth of platinum, but just denominate them as $1 trillion, and then deposit them with the Treasury on account and pay down the national debt, and we would no longer have to pay interest on the debt, and just that would just resolve that issue. Is that crazy?
No. It's consistent with the notion that, look, if the government can print money as the way to get the money supply controlled, print it and use it to buy things that the government needs, our roads, our schools, and all the rest, and then tax us to pull the money back out of the economy when that is necessary, then, of course, the government is no longer in hock to private lenders to the government. What happens now is that the government is pushed by politicians to lower taxes, because that's how they get reelected, but it has to at the same time provide all these services that both business and the public want, and it solves this absurd contradiction by borrowing money. And so we have a bigger and bigger debt. It's now in the many trillions of dollars, our national debt. It burdens us. And the whole idea is, maybe with modern monetary theory, if the government just prints the money and uses it as needed, it won't have to borrow more, and it could use that capacity to retire the old debt too. That's one of the positive aspects of this idea.